Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome again to another painting tutorial. Today we'll be doing a flower painting and I chose a pink calla lily. So I will do my best to make it as simple as possible and also to make it as realistic as possible. We will only be using a few colors today because this is a focus subject painting, meaning we are painting the subject as if it's close to us. Okay, we will not be doing a lot of impressionistic strokes. So here are the colors that we'll be using for today's painting tutorial. We have red, sap green, white or titanium white, primary blue, and black, and a little bit of yellow. So all the colors that I just mentioned will be listed in the description box below so that you can refer to them anytime you find my speaking quite too fast. All right, so I'm gonna sketch first the subject. We will not be backgrounding the canvas paper that I'll be using for today's tutorial. You can simply use your plain white canvas. We want it to be simple, focused, and realistic. So I'm gonna sketch first the subject. For the sketch, I'll be using some gray. So I'm gonna mix my white and black. This is just for sketching. So if other colors are mixing, it doesn't really matter. But gray is a good base for this, okay? Because we'll be doing a pink subject. So using this gray color, I'm gonna start sketching it. I will definitely make some adjustments if necessary later. Because my tendency is to make my subject bigger so it occupies a lot of space, and then because I really don't trace my paintings, for me tracing is a tool that you can use, but it's not something that will really help you to become better. That's my opinion. It will help you achieve something, but when you're on your own, it will not really make you any better. I hope I'm making sense and I hope I'm not hurting your feelings if you're using the tracing method. I know that some people will tell me that even the masters, like let's say, I don't know, I'm not sure, but even the masters, maybe Vermeer other famous painters, they use some tracing techniques like grids and all that. Yeah, you can always say that and justify your tracing, but I know for sure too that they can paint without it, right? Anyway, yes, so we just sketch it. I will definitely make some adjustments here because I feel like it's kind of small, right? Just like that. And then I'm gonna use a bigger brush. Okay, I'm gonna make it quite fat because we want to balance it. Okay, now I want to use a large brush so that I get larger coverage. Still, we're using gray, so just paint this gray. I know that I said we'll be painting a pink calla lily, but we're trying to underpaint first. Okay, I think I made this a little darker. Okay. Just add white. Okay, just like that. And definitely we will be allowing this to dry first before we proceed to doing the pink ones or the pink colors. Okay, I'm gonna allow this first to dry. Let's move to another part of the flower, which is the leaves. Okay, I'm gonna use my green. Just use your sap green and let's create like a bud. Okay, just like that. And I'm gonna mix my green with the black. Okay, just like that. Okay, and using the same color, green, I'm gonna add a little bit of blue. Okay, we want to make some darker green down here because it's not really receiving too much light. This is the what they call that? The cup. I call it the cup that holds the petals together. Right? So sap green, blue, a little bit of red. I'm gonna add more blue. Okay, like that. Okay, the same thing going on. Some light blue colors. I mean, light blue green. Okay. Okay, definitely will make this will make sense later. For now, let's just do the initial or the preparatory colors. All right, just like that. Wash your brush out. I'm gonna get my black. I'm gonna darken this area. All right. I think the underpainting for the flower is already, it's quite dry. It's dry enough for us to layer over it. So get your red, because we'll be doing some pink colors, as I told you. Oh, what happened here? Okay, we will detail leaves later. For now, let's just proceed to doing the petals. So using some red and white, we will create some pinky color. So I'm gonna get my red. Okay. Okay, maybe here, I'm not sure. My palette is quite wet. So red plus white. Okay, maybe this, more red, and a little bit of black. All right, let's start. So as you can see here, I'm following a pattern. I'm going downwards or following the shape of the petal. I'm not going super horizontal. I'm following the shape. Okay, so follow the shape of the petals. Also here. Okay, I need to make it more dark. Okay, just like that. And then I'm gonna make it more red and then black. I'm gonna try. Here as well. Okay, just like that. Alright, just like that. Okay, I'm gonna wash my brush out a little. Let's go back to some light pink. So I'm gonna get my red and white, a little bit of black. Okay, and I'm gonna get more white. Just gonna make some highlights. That's too white, I guess. Okay, I think I'm gonna switch to another brush just to have something or a separate brush for dark colors. So I'm gonna get my red, pure red. And as you can see here, I love using my fingers directly touching the canvas. I feel more connected to my painting if I do this. So don't worry if you're dirtying your canvas like me. I just accidentally applied some red paints. It's all right. Now using my dark red, I'm just gonna darken the innermost portion of the flower. If you don't want to use black in darkening your color, you can use other colors like green or blue. Right. I'm gonna darken even more some areas. Okay, now let's go back to some light pink. Some white. Some white right here. Okay, I'm gonna go back to the leaves or to the petals later. Let's go to the bud right here. I'm gonna get my black. Or maybe I need black because I already ran out of black. Using black, I'm just gonna darken this area. This is to give this bud a little dimension. Also here. Okay, just like that. I'm gonna get my yellow. Okay. And then green. Just like that, and some yellow greeny colors. And maybe white to suggest a background leaf. Just like that. making using white. Let's highlight. Just like that. We will correct some areas now. Okay, and this one, it's bothering me. Okay, just like that. Using pure white, I'm just gonna make some more highlights. Some white right here. Okay, like that. Also here. And here. Maybe not white, but a little bit of bluish grayish color. Some more red, and I'm gonna spread it like upwards to create a more realistic pattern. Okay. I'm using white. Okay. Okay. Now I'll be using a little bit of gray. Because we want some dimension. Like some dimension, some folds on the petals. Okay. Let me check. Still using white. Let's lighten this area. Also this. Okay, now let's do some more, like the pollens. I'm gonna use my black. Oh, no. My white. And yellow, maybe a little bit of green. Let's create some pollens. You may want to use another finer brush. All right. And using a small brush, I'm gonna get my black. I'm gonna mix the black with the red. Okay, now before we highlight the pollens, you may want to make some adjustments. You can actually thin. I'm just gonna thin down those pollens that I just created. I feel like they're just so fat. We don't want them to be super, super fat. I'm just allowing this to dry first because I'm gonna layer it with some darker colors. Now, since I'm at it already, I'm just gonna use this finer brush to create more detailing on certain areas while, you know, while waiting for the paint to dry. I'm gonna get my white and I'm trying to create more details. Just like that. Okay. Now using some red and black, I'm gonna slightly paint over so that I create that like gradient effect. Okay, just like that. All right, so did you get what I wanted to do? So the centermost portion of the flower should be a little darker because it's not really receiving good light. I mean, good amount of light. Okay, now let's create some light passing through, from the inside. I'm gonna get my green. Let's create some, yeah, like this. It's just a little hint of translucence. I'm gonna get my white. Very subtle, but it's there. Okay. Now let's go to detailing the pollens. I'm gonna get my white. This highlight. Okay, some yellows. A little bit of yellow hints on the petals, just a little. Sometimes we really don't notice these details, but they are there. Just try to observe. You see white. Okay. And then some lighter green. Just lighten it. Let me check. This looks nice. So now I'm gonna glaze using some pink. Okay. Excuse me. Okay. I'm gonna get some more white. I'm just gonna paint over some areas. Okay. So I'm just cleaning it. And then I'm gonna darken again. Some areas. Okay, I absolutely love this. Okay, this is nice and simple. Okay, I think I have to sign this now. This is all right, right? So I'm gonna sign this now. Wait, my. Okay. And I'm gonna use black. Since I do have a lot of black. All right, maybe I'm just gonna add one more detailing. Oops. Okay, and that is white. Okay. All right, I think this is done. What do you think? I think this is done. So I hope you enjoy this one. And I hope you do this one as well. If you're painting along with me, let me know in the comment section below. If you have painted along with me in the past, let me know as well in the comment section below. And see you in my next one. Bye, guys. Love you.